So many financial blessings are going to what? Come on us and overflow and overtake us. How many of us love for financial blessings to come on and overtake us? Amen. Blessed going out. How many want to be blessed going out? Hey, how many want to be blessed coming in? Amen. How many want wealth and riches to be in our house? Amen. I'm going to do everything to erase all these sad looks and so riches and blessings can, amen, can what? Be in your house. Y'all get to put your arms around me. Wealth and riches shall be in your what? House. Amen. All these empty bank accounts are going to what? All of a sudden begin to what? Amen. Money is going to start flowing into them. Bible says if we delight ourselves in the Lord, He will give us into what? Desires of our heart. And I guarantee you, everybody got a desire for more money.
Yeah.
Amen. God said, what? Wipe away them sad looks. Come into agreement with what I have to offer you. Place yourself in a position where I can what? Pour. But see, Jesus said, I'm come that you might have what? Life. And might have life what? More. Amen. God is not a what? He's not a person that's what? Trying to what? Take something from you.
Alright.
He's trying to what? Get something to you.
Yeah.
How many can say amen?
Amen?
So we have to place ourselves in a position where God's blessings can reach us. How many want to do that? Amen. And how do you do that? Praise God. Is it y'all everybody see me?
Yeah.
5 o'clock in the morning. Amen. Handalama sandalama sandal. Lord, you delighted in mercy. Lord, your eyes are running to and fro throughout the whole earth. You're looking for somebody. You're looking for me. Hey, you're looking for somebody to pour your blessings out on. Amen. Every single one of those scriptures that I'm going to give you today that promises you that God is eager. He wants to do this in your life so bad. And all He's waiting for you to do is what? Get out of your bed. So I said, well, I'll never get it, but that's up to you. Praise Him. Praise Him. Amen. You have to place yourself in a position where God's blessings can be what? Released into your life. How many can say amen? Amen. Place yourself in a position. And I'm going to be bawling and squalling. I mean, this is going to be joy. Oh, glory. Bible says, shout for joy. Amen. Fear not, O ye lands. Rejoice and be glad. Glory. I'm going to try to be as glad as I can get this week. Amen. Because the Bible says, if we rejoice and be glad, the Lord will do great things. How many want to see God do some new things in your life? Hey, lift your hands and give Him praise this morning. That's what He's going to do. Amen. I've never been the same since that 30 days. Sister Dorothy called. She, I don't know why she did it. She just said, Pastor Hill, I feel led to do a 30-day prayer meeting. I said, amen. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. Boy, that 30-day prayer meeting has meant more to me recently than anything I can think of. Amen. But that's just a tip of the iceberg of what God is about to do.
Yeah.
Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. So how many are going to join me this week? Say praise the Lord.
Amen.
Everybody say praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
You're going to miss out on a whole lot of things because you're going to miss out on the Word. But I'm going to be flat teaching the Word in the morning and night. We're going to be doing it. I'm going to give you a whole lot of stuff that you can just affirm yourself into. Amen. Joy and victory and blessings.
Amen.
I'm just going to be passing it out. If you don't show up, amen, praise God. Maybe next year we'll do it again. Every evening, praise God, I'm going to be pouring out my heart because it's not, amen, I want to see you really blessed. And I know that you are not going to be blessed by not making a sacrifice and by standing at home looking at TV, twiddling your thumbs, amen. And looking wise and otherwise. Amen. It's going to have to be a sacrifice. That's what we're going to. Amen. Praise God. Be focusing on this week. All right. Now, these things that the Lord spoke to me about seven things that produces the highest kind of faith, the reality of His redemption, the reality of a new creation, You have to be convinced that God's nature is really in you. Amen. I am of God.
Yes.
We are of God, little children. And greater is He that is in us. How many believe that God is working in you now?
Yes.
When you begin to praise God and really begin to enjoy, amen, the fullness of His glory, His presence, His power, that's the thing that makes God on the inside of you what real.
Yes.
How many can say amen? Amen. I think you need some feelings sometimes. Somebody said, well, faith ain't feelings. But one of the things that enables you, amen, to experience the end results of things that God has promised you vicariously, amen, is that your worship. Amen. Most times when you get in worship, your pains leave. How many can say amen? If they are existing, you can't feel them. How many can say amen? It puts you into a realm where you feel like the reality of the manifestations of what you're believing for, amen, you already what have them. Amen. That's the thing that really enables you, amen, to experience the reality of the things that's not seen, amen, before they are even manifested, amen, praise God, physically. So we want to just explore these things, reality of our righteousness, the reality of His indwelling presence, the reality of our fellowship with the Father, and knowing the authority of Jesus' name. Amen. So we just want to throw those things out. These are going to be some of the things that we're going to be sharing on this week. But the Lord's attribute, which is the greatest attribute of all, is God's benevolence. God's benevolence. That means God is disposed to show in favor. Amen. He's a God that what? Loves to show favor. Amen. Everybody just take somebody here. You say, you know what a favor is? Amen. A favor is something that you get without what? Doing anything for. Amen. The Bible says that God's grace is what? God's unmerited favor. How many can say amen? God doing for you what you can't do for yourself. Amen. It's God's riches at Christ's expense. Amen. So God is disposed to show in favor. And that's what the first verse that we read, Psalms 145, said, verse 8 said, God is gracious.
Yes.
He's gracious.
Yes.
Amen. When you think about somebody gracious, it's somebody who's real nice, kind, friendly, always what want to find out how they can help you. You say, that person is what? They sure are gracious. Amen. How many want to be a gracious person?
Amen.
Disposed to showing favor. So that's the greatest attribute, amen, of our Father God. He is disposed. In other words, He is inclined to what? Show favor. Amen. So I guess if you had to sum up the grace, the work of grace in just one word, one phrase, I would say God's grace simply means that God is really for you. God is really for you. We have a whole lot of definitions of grace. We already know that, right? But all of these definitions show that God is really for you. Amen. He really is concerned. Scripture says He's touched with the feelings of our infirmity. He's a merciful and a very compassionate high priest. Amen. So that same verse says He's gracious and full of compassion. Amen. Compassion means mercy. It means God's love in action. It means to be very pitiful and tender mercy. Amen. And this describes the very nature, the very attribute of God. God is just very pitiful and of tender mercies. Amen. Amen. Scripture, there's another scripture I want you to turn to, which gives us a little bigger, deeper insight. It says that Psalms 86:5, hallelujah, Psalms 86:5, but Psalms 145, verses 8 and 9, you know, throughout that chapter, even 14, 15, 16, 18, 19, it would just be good to just read the entire chapter because it's all focusing on the Lord's compassion. And if you really want to get a real good description of how merciful and how passionate, how compassionate, and how full of eager yearning that God is. You can look at the history of God's dealings with Israel, and I think that one of the better ones is in Nehemiah, when we talked about how God delivered them from the hands of the enemy after 430 years of their affliction. They cried out to God, and the Bible says God heard their cry, and he delivered them out of their distresses. And all through the wilderness experience, amen, they faced challenge after challenge after challenge after challenge. But the hand of God was what consistently directing, guiding, and God led them by day by a pillar of what? Cloud. And by night by what? Pillar of fire. There are so many mercies. There are so many instances of God's love and God's compassion and God's concern for them. In that Nehemiah 9, if you need to read that, and we went over that, amen, several Sundays ago, Nehemiah 9, everybody said Nehemiah. Amen. See, it's a lot in reading. When you read and really get to the root of God's heart, God's heartbeat, when you can really understand God's heartbeat, then it's just going to build your confidence. It's going to make you more excited. Worship is going to be a pleasure because you know that God is what? He's eagerly, amen, waiting for the opportunity to pour out on you, amen, the fullness of his benefits and blessings that he has already provided through Christ. Amen. He's just eagerly waiting for the opportunity, amen, to pour these blessings out to you, for, amen, in you, in his fullness. Amen. Praise God. So Nehemiah 9, verses 7 through 38 will give you, amen, a real good description of God's mercies to Israel throughout that 40 years of wanderings in the wilderness, and even after they got into Canaan. But Psalms 86, verse 5, it says, "For thou, Lord, art good and ready to forgive." Hallelujah. "And plenteous in mercy unto all of them that call upon thee." Amen. So I have these attributes listed this way. God is disposed to show in favor. He's gracious and full of compassion. Amen. Praise God. He's full of grace. Amen. There's a scripture, first St. John 1:14. It says, Jesus, amen, Christ, full of grace and what? True. Full of grace. Amen. I'm going to just turn there. Because this scripture says he's plenteous in mercy unto all of them that call upon him. Amen. Turn to St. John 14. This is St. John 1, 14. Amen. I'm just building my case, and I'm going to thoroughly convince you that you need to rejoice, amen, in God like you are crazy, because God is what? He's really for you. I mean, he's seeking every opportunity for his blessings to be released into your life, amen, in the measure that he has designed them to be. He just wants you to be, amen, he wants your cup overflowing. Amen, he wants to run you over with his blessings. Amen, no wonder David says, "Surely goodness and mercy shall what? Follow me all the days of my life." God wants goodness and mercy to what? Follow us. He wants our lives to be what? Full of what? Goodness. Full of what? Mercy. Hallelujah. St. John 1:14, word was made flesh. Everybody see that? "And dwelt among us, and we beheld his glory, the glory as of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth." All those that beheld Christ, amen, the grace of God was upon them. Hallelujah. It was one thing that people recognized when they came into the presence of Jesus. Even the sinners and even the thieves and all of those low class folk, when they got in Jesus' presence, they knew it was something about him that caused him to be different than anybody else. Different from the Pharisees, the Sadducees, the scribes, and all of the religious leaders. It was a love. They felt comfortable. They felt that he amen, they could approach him. They felt they could, what, amen, cast their needs and their cares and their sorrows and bring to Jesus all of their concerns. They felt that because they saw the grace of God. It was something about him that displayed his love, that showed and manifested how much he was concerned. He was touched, scripture says, repeatedly, when Jesus saw the leper, he was what, moved with compassion. The two men that cried out, Lord, amen, thou two blind men. They were crying out, thou son of David, they never had seen. Thou son of David, thou son of David, have mercy on me. The Bible says when Jesus heard that, those cries, he stood still. Amen. Amen. He was a great multitude, but Jesus stood still. And he told the multitude, amen, the multitude had to what? Make room for those two men to come where Jesus was. Because the scripture says Jesus had compassion on them and laid his hands on their eyes and they received sight. Jesus is full of compassion. Boy, if you could be convinced of all of these 14 or 15 scriptures that I have for you to meditate, for you to chew on, and to eat on, and to rejoice over. Amen. And just feed your spirit. Amen. Praise God. God delighteth in mercy. His eyes are running to and fro throughout the whole earth to show himself strong on the behalf of those whose hearts are perfect before him. The Lord God is a sun and shield. Hallelujah. Amen. Praise God. He will, amen, he will not withhold his glory. Hallelujah. No good thing will he withhold from them that what? Walketh upright. Hallelujah. These scriptures, amen, got to become meaningful. How many know that these scriptures can become meaningful? And when these scriptures become meaningful, when they become alive and real to you, amen, your heart will rejoice when everybody got their head down around you. You lift your head in the midst of your discouragement and the frustration, your anxieties, and all that you're going through. Amen. And you would just say, it's God's good pleasure to give me the kingdom. Oh, the kingdom of God is not meat and drink. Hey, but they are righteousness, joy, peace in the Holy Ghost. Joy in the Holy Ghost. Kingdom of God is not meat and drink, but it's what? Righteousness, peace, joy. Everybody that said joy. Joy in the Holy Ghost. Oh, God's word is what? Food, hallelujah, for your soul. Life to them that find it. And I want to put in your disposal every scripture I can share with you to let you know that God is what? Full of compassion. He's gracious. Everybody say he's gracious. He's gracious. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. That means to you what he desires and what show favor. He desires to meet you at your point of need. He's a merciful and compassionate high priest that's touched with the feelings of your infirmity. And then he says, amen, praise God. Come boldly. Don't hold your head down, amen, like a dog with his tail between his legs. How ya? Come boldly. Step up to the throne. Hey, make your request known unto me. Hey, come and receive mercy. Oh, how many can say amen? How many know that joy is mercy? Peace is mercy. Healing is mercy. Strength is mercy. Blessings are mercy. Finances are what? Mercy.
Glory to God.
Amen. No wonder when we look at the history of Israel, we have all of these names ascribed to Jehovah. Jehovah, what? Jireh, y'all name them. Shalom, and Nisi, and Shammah. Yes, and all of these, because God said that through my compound names, I'll make provision for everything you'll ever need. From the time you get here, from the time that you call home, and when you call home, amen, you won't need all of this earthly stuff no more, right? Somebody can say amen. Oh, how many love him today? How many love him today? How many love him today? How many love him? Oh, I'm going to love him. I'm going to, amen, perfect. This week, I'm going to perfect my love. Amen, for his goodness and for his mercy. I'm going to do it just a little bit better. I'm going to get a little bit closer.
Yes, Lord, I'll be right with you.
Your name. Now I just want you to understand all of these scriptures full of grace. I just got through reading that. Full of grace and what? Truth. Plenteous and mercy. We just got through reading that. Here's one here that these are scriptures that you can take down, because all of these scriptures are scriptures that you're going to hear this week as we pray, as we affirm, as we, amen, say ourselves happy. I just thought, talking about scriptures when I come to pray. I just begin to what? Let scriptures begin to what? Come out of my mouth. That makes me real happy. Makes me feel real good. And when I get full of the word, amen, all I do is just side with God. That's all I say. Just whatever God says in there. And here's a good one here. Romans 10. I'm going to give you this one. Romans 10, 12. This is a real good one, and you definitely want this one this week. Amen. You got to have this one. Romans 10, 12. Amen. These are scriptures that really builds my confidence and faith up in God's love and God's care for me. And when I go through scripture, I just weep and cry, because it warms my heart so.
Yes.
Bible says the word is life to them that what? Fight. And it's what healing. Healing to all of their what? Flesh.
Yes.
Amen. The scripture just melts my heart every time. Romans 12. You know, sometimes these scriptures don't mean anything to a lot of people. But we're going to have to work with these scriptures until they really become what? Meaningful.
Yes.
They become alive. All of these scriptures I'm giving you are scriptures that you really need to take down. Romans 10, verse 12. It says this. Amen. I'm going to start with the 11th verse. It says, For the scripture said, whosoever believeth on him shall not be ashamed. Amen. Shall not be ashamed. Amen. Whatever God promises, whatever God says he will do, you will never be what? Ashamed. He's going to fulfill his word. In other words, he's going to stand behind his word to what? Make it good. All he wants you to do is open your mouth and what? You meditate it. Open your mouth and release those words, amen, that release God's power to bring that word, amen, praise God, that word alive in your heart. Amen. You have to agree with the word. You have to say things. Amen. This is how our faith is built. This is how we grow. This is how we develop. This is how the joy of the Lord is released. This is how we get the victory. This is how we overcome. The Bible says we overcome by the blood. Amen. And the what? Word of our testimony. We have to keep the word in our what? Mouth. Instead of keeping all this other junk in your mouth. You can always find a whole lot of negative stuff what to say. Amen. To agree with or to affirm. But this scripture says that there's no difference, hallelujah, between the Jew and the Greek. For the same Lord over all is rich unto all that call upon him. For whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. Oh, I love that. I love it. Amen. He is the same Lord over all, is rich unto all that call upon him. That is so precious. He's rich unto all that call upon him. Scripture says his eyes are upon the righteous and his ears are what? Open to their cry. His hand ain't short, but he can't see. Neither his ear heavy that he can't hear. Amen. But you have to what? Open and make the way for those blessings that God wants to release in your life so badly. You have to make that possible. Amen. You have to what? You have to do some things. Amen. How many would just appreciate God coming in, amen, against your permission, without your participation and cooperation, and forcing himself and making you, amen, cooperate and agree with him? You wouldn't like that. Amen. Is that right? God is a perfect gentleman. He's not going to move until what? You move. Amen. There's one thing about it. If God doesn't move, amen, I move him. Amen. How many here say amen? You can move him. If God don't move like you want him to move, you can what? Move him. You know how you move him? By getting in line with the word. How many can say amen? Amen. We overcome by the blood of the Lamb. See, we are bought with a price. Christ paid an awesome price. Amen. For all of these blessings that he has provided for us. Amen. Amen. He paid an awful price. That's the reason why. Amen. He's rich unto all that call. All that call upon him. He's rich. In other words, he's eagerly awaiting for the opportunity to what? To just flood you out with all of the blessings that pertains unto life and unto godliness. Amen. See, God really wants to do this. And here's another scripture that I'm going to give you that, amen, you need to keep in your mouth. This is the scripture that we're going to build up with prayer meetings on. Amen. Amen. From now on. Amen. And as we begin to build our prayer meetings on all these scriptures that pertains to God's mercies, amen, it's just going to fill you with joy unspeakable and full of glory. I mean, you're just going to get so happy. Amen. How many of you have been so happy until you feel like, amen, you couldn't hardly see in your skin no more? You know what? Sometimes I get real happy in my house. Amen. So he'll be sleeping. I can't color out like I want to. Amen. Amen. Praise God. And what I just walk through the house. I just be real happy. Just be real happy. Thank the Lord. Lord, you delight in mercy. You eyes. I'm running to and fro. Throughout the whole earth, you're looking for somebody's heart that's open for you. Somebody that's willing to what? Open the door and let me in. Somebody that's willing to, hey, praise God, to place themselves in a position where my love and my blessings, my mercy, my compassion can come on them and overtake them. Amen. And here's a scripture. The scripture I just gave you, that's one I think about all the time. Amen. Praise God. Amen. In Romans 11, 10 and verse, I just got to read it, 10. Hallelujah. It says that, for there is no difference between the Jew and the Greek. See, God don't have no respect of person. Is that right? You don't care how high you are, how low, how many times you missed it. You don't care about your level of intelligence. He doesn't care who likes you or who doesn't like you. Bible says, Peter said, I perceive that God is no respecter of person. But in every nation, he that feareth him and worketh righteousness is accepted. All God wants us to do is to get in line. Get in line. Get in agreement. Amen. Place ourselves in a position where he can what? Begin to what? Turn some of these things around. Hallelujah. He's rich. Oh, I love it. Lamanishi kashalamo shekilamaha. He's rich unto all of them that call upon him. And one scripture says, he's rich unto all that call upon him in truth. He got to have some rules. He just can't pour out of these precious blessings upon you, amen, without any kind of what? Any kind of what? Rules. Amen. He can't transgress his moral what, laws and his word, amen, to what? To bless you, although he wants to bless you more than you what, desire to be blessed. Yeah. But you got to what? Place yourself in a position. Amen. Great multitudes of people came to Jesus for healing. You know what the Bible says? They came to hear him and to be healed of all of their diseases. See, they placed themselves in a position. They came to what? Hear him. Everybody say, hear him. See, everybody is not willing to what? Hear. See, the only reason why all of these blessings are ours, and the scripture says he's blessed us with every spiritual blessing. God ain't short, slow concerning his promise. He ain't limited. Amen. He got a whole lot of stuff ready to come down your what? Your way. He's just waiting for you to what? Clear the land. Open the door. Place yourself in a position. Amen. Romans 8. He's rich. Everybody just say he's rich unto all that call upon him. See, if you don't ever call on him, if you don't ever accept nothing, if you don't ever what? Agree with him. If you don't what? Pray the word. Sing the word. How am I going to shake? Kela lama. That's what I'm saying. That come into agreement. You have to what? Amen. Agree with him. Come into agreement. Amen. Praise God. I love that. Romans 8:32. This is see, all of these scriptures are scriptures that, boy, I just chew on. Tear. These produce tears. These produce joy. These make you get very confident about your what, loving Heavenly Father. This proves beyond a shadow of a doubt that God is what? For you. Hey! This proves that no good thing that he will withhold from them that what? Walk upright before him. Hallelujah! This shows that God, praise God, he's a God, he's a faithful God that keepeth covenant. Oh, my house. He keepeth covenant with them that what? Love him. Them that what? Obey him. And those that walk before him with all of their heart. Hallelujah. Romans 8:32. Oh, I love this right here. This is the reason why Jesus is able, amen, to do it. See, all of these blessings and provisions, even in the Old Testament, and all of these things that Israel, these benefits and blessings that Israel enjoyed, you know, God being the those seven compound names, how God manifested his compassion, amen, for Israel all throughout their existence. God was able to do that on the grounds of the provisions that he was going to make through his son, Jesus Christ. The scripture says, he was a lamb slain before the foundation of the world. So he could, amen, amen. See, God has to have a reason to do everything he does. How many can say amen? How many can say amen? So he can bless us once we get in position, once we what, repent, once we believe on him and receive him. The scripture says, as many as receive him, to them he gives them what, the authority to become the sons of God. Yes. Amen. Praise God. So he can, amen, he has certain things, but the only way God can bless us is through his redemptive, amen, work. How many can say amen? Yes. But he knew beforehand that he was going to be the lamb slain. And he said, well, because, amen, amen, this is, although this is in the future, amen, I'll let them draw on it, amen, amen, 4,000 or 5,000 years or 2,000 or 3,000 or 1,000 years before I even go to the cross, I'll let them draw and get the benefits now. Hey, ha, ha. That's the reason why Israel enjoyed so many of God's what, blessings. Because these blessings were contingent upon what? Christ's what? Redemption. Jesus said, yes, I'll lay down my life. Oh, I come in the volume of the book that's written of me to do your will. He said, not my will, O Father, but thy will be done. But that was already what I agreed on, amen, before the foundation of the world. So the blessings were made available in advance. How many can say amen? How many can say amen? How many can say amen? How many remember Israel going out of Egypt? Over 2.5 million people. The Bible says he brought them forth with what? Silver and gold. And there was not one what? Feeble person among their tribes. He sent his word. and he healed them. Yes. How many know that was a mercy under the old covenant? Jesus hadn't died, but they drew on the blessings that would come through his redemption.